So on the series of learning programming in C, we are discussing pointers in C. In the previous lecture, I have discussed some basics about pointers, like what is pointer, how to declare a pointer, how to initialize a pointer, all the basic points about pointers. I hope you got that lecture, right? So in this video, we'll talk about two special operators which are used when we deal with pointers. One is this ampersand, which is called as address of operator or referencing operator. I guess you are familiar with this operator. It give what? Address of any variable, right? This one is this one, asterisk operator. It is known as indirection operator, or you can say dereferencing operator. This is very important when you deal with pointers, and many students get confused while using this operator with pointers. They think that it's very tough, right? They don't know how to use this operator. What's the meaning of this operator? But this we will discuss in this video with proper example in simple language, in simple terms, right? I'll show you a program. First of all, here on the whiteboard, we'll see dry run that program. We'll see how you are getting that kind of output, and everything we'll discuss. And then I'll show you practically on my laptop. We'll write down some code also, right? In the previous video, I have told you like size of pointer. And many students ask me this doubt, like what should be size of pointer? So see, size of pointer depends on machine, or you can say depends on the compiler. On a 16-bit machine or a 16-bit compiler, size of pointer would be 2 byte, and on a 32-bit machine it would be 4 byte, right? It depends, either size would be 2 byte or 4 byte, right? Maybe in the previous video I guess I have told you like 2 byte on 32-bit machine, but no, 2 byte would be on 16-bit, and for 32-bit machine size of pointer would be 4 byte, right? Here, I think you are clear with this. If I write like I am declaring a variable like int a is equal to 10, and suppose I am taking b also, b is equal to 9, right? And here I am taking a pointer p, and one pointer is two pointer I am taking, p and q, right? So this line, when this line will be executed, it means we have a variable a, we have a variable b, some memory has been allocated here. In a I have 10, in b I have value of b is 9. And suppose address is, suppose I am taking 1000 and address of this is 2000. It's like base address, because int will take 4 byte. So in 4 byte, like address would be 1000. If base address, the address of the starting byte is 1000, then 1001, 1002, 1003. That would be for this variable. But obviously address will take what? The base address, means the address of the first byte of that integer. So suppose this is 1000 and this is 2000. So here we have a pointer, two pointers suppose. One is P, one is Q. They are also having some, obviously they are also variables. These are special variables which will store address of any other variable. But also they will occupy some size, some memory in your computer memory, right? So an address, obviously there would be some address. So suppose address of this pointer is 3046, address of this is like 2046. Maybe, I don't know. What is the address? And right now they are not pointing to anything because we haven't initialized these pointers, right? So how to initialize these pointer? If I write p is equal to address of a, it means address of a is now 1000, so 1000 would be stored in p. So now p is pointing to a. And suppose I am writing q is equal to address of b, so address of b is 2000, so 2000 would be here and this is pointing to b. Means P points to A, Q points to B, right? And we are taking int here, int star P and star Q means whatever address this P will contain, right? Or you can say P will store address of a variable whose data type is integer. Q also store address of variable whose data type is integer, and that is fine. A and B both are integer, right? So address of operator, see the meaning of this is why we use to take address of any variable. Address of means it will return address of A, that is 1000, and that would be assigned to P. So I guess this operator is clear to you. Generally we use this in scanf, right? Scanf percentage D and address of, like if variable I am taking like address of A or address of B. So scanf will take what? Address of that variable, and whatever value will enter, that will, that is going to store the address you provide in scanf, right? So I guess this is clear to you. Or you can say this is reference operator. We also call address as reference, right? Now see, if I want to print, or if I want to access value of a and b, how you can print? There can be multiple ways. Or here, see, it is also fine. Someone asked me like if I can write address of A comma address of B. Is it correct? Yes, it is correct. But here, see, two operators are there. One is comma and one is assignment operator. And precedence of assignment operator is higher than comma operator. Means first assignment would be executed. So it means P is equal to address of A. Assignment operator would be executed. So whatever to the right side of this assignment operator, that would be assigned to this P, right? So this is what, something like this. Here in this case, if you write this, then address of A would be assigned to P, means 1000 would be assigned to this P, not address of B. This is the meaning of this statement, right? And if you write something like this, right? I have discussed comma operator in the previous videos, so you can check out that in detail. So now this brackets are having higher precedence, obviously, then assignment and then comma. So this would be executed, right? First, then assignment operator. And comma is what? The working of comma is what? First operand would be executed, evaluated, and discard the result, then evaluate second operand and return the value. So now address of A 1000, but it will discard this. Now address of B will be taken, that is 2000, and it will return 2000. So now 2000 will be stored in P. So now P will contain 2000. I hope you got the difference, right? You can check out the video of comma operator, then you will get it better. Comma we can use as a separator and as a operator also, right? So this is also fine, right? But here I am writing like Q is equal to address of B. Or you can also write something like this. P is equal to address of B. In this case, if this line would be executed, address of A would be assigned here, 1000. Now next line would be executed. Now address of B is 2000. So now 2000 would be assigned here, and now P will point to here. Right? We have now address of A is, we are not having address of A in any pointer variable, right? So now I guess this is clear to you. Or we can say more than one pointer can point to a single variable, like Q is equal to address of A. This is also fine. In both the pointers, now address of A would be stored, 1000 and 1000. So now Q is also pointing to this A. Q is not pointing to B. This is also fine, right? But here I am writing Q is having address of B. Fine. Now, see, okay, if I want to print value of A is equal to percentage D, and simply I can write A. And what would be the output? 10. Now, we can also access this value using this pointer, because we have address of this A. So using this pointer also we can print the value. Maybe like this is what, this is name, like this is what Ankit, and Ankit address is what, maybe house number 34, South City, something like this, right? And this is what, pointer is what, maybe friend of Ankit, like you can say Pulkit, right? So if I am third person, if I don't know address of Ankit, and I want to access Ankit, I want to go to, you know, Ankit's home, but I know Pulkit, right? So now ultimately I know Pulkit, I can go to Pulkit, and Pulkit is having address of Ankit. I mean, in Pulkit now we have like 34 and South Delhi and this kind of thing. So Pulkit is having address of Ankit, so using Pulkit I can reach to Ankit. This is the case, right? So using this pointer P, I can access value of A. Now how to print this value? Printf, value of A is equal to percentage D. Now see, if you will print simply P, what would be the output? In P I have 1000, sorry, not 2000. We have 1000, and in Q I have 2000, because in P I am storing address of A, in Q I am storing address of B. So now the diagram is, I guess, correct, right? So now what would be the output? In P we have 1000, so 1000 would be printed. But 1000 is what? Address of A. And I want value of A, that is 10 I want to print, right? So for printing the value, we use this operator, indirection operator, or you can say dereferencing operator, right? So if you write something like this, asterisk p, it means whatever the value at this address, that would be printed. So simply indirection operator is used to print value at address, right? So now in p we have 1000, but we have written asterisk here, it means value at 1000. Value at 1000 is 10. So now 10 would be printed. Means see, star p is equal to, you can write something like this, this asterisk, and p is what? P is what? Address of A. You can write this also. Rather than p, you can write address of A. Right? Now star address of A is 1000 and value at 1000 is 10. So 10 would be printed. So it is used to print value at that address. I guess the use of this indirection operator is clear to you, right? Now if you want to print address of A, then how you can print printf? Address of A is equal to, and if you want to print like address would be obviously in hexadecimal form, or if you use percentage u, unsigned integer value would be printed. So if you want to print in hexadecimal form, then use percentage x. I'll show you practically. You can print address of A. This will give you what value? Address of A is 1000. Not 1000. If you are using x, then some address would be in hexadecimal form. Like maybe 61, F, E, C, D, something like this would be printed. I don't know, but I'll show you practically, right? Another way is what? In P also we have address of A, right? Address of A. So simply if you will print printf address of A equal to percentage x and P, it will also give you 1000. Not 1000, in hexadecimal form, maybe 61FECD, something like this. This and this will give same output, right? And any other case would be, if you want to print address of P, like this, address of P is 3046 in integer form, right? I'm just assuming this address is this one, right? So simply you can print printf address of P is equal to, if you want to print print in hexadecimal form, use percentage x, and simply you have to print address of P. That's it. It will give address of P. Whatever the address of P, that will be printed. Right? So I guess you are clear with these two operators, why we are using these two operators and how to access value of a variable using pointer. Here we are using this pointer. Right? So now one question for you is, I'm taking one more variable, int c. Right? And after this line, after semicolon, I'm writing c is equal to asterisk q, right? I'm writing this, and here after this printf, I'm going to print printf value of c is equal to percentage d and c. What would be the value of c at last? What would be the output, right? You have to tell me in comment box. And if you write something like this, after this in the same program, I'm writing here, I'm writing here, after this I'm writing one more statement, like asterisk p equal to 20, right? And after this I want to print what? Printf, I want to print value of A, right? So what would be value of A? A is equal to percentage d. What would be value of A and what would be value of p? Percentage, or you can say x, or whatever you write here, and here I'm going to print p only. So what would be the output of these two things as well as this one, C? You have to tell me in comment box, right? If you got what is address of an indirection operator, the working, you can easily answer these questions, right? See here, I guess you can tell this thing, because star Q I have written, it means value, asterisk means value at address. Now in Q I have address of B, in Q I have 2000, means value Asterisk 2000 mean value at 2000, value at 2000. 2000 is this address and value is 9. So 9 would be stored in C, I guess, right? So 9 would be printed. I hope you got it and you can, you know, answer this question. So now let me show you practically this thing on my laptop. So now let me create a file and I'm writing the name pointer, suppose intro.c, right? So first header file will use then main function and will take a variable int a is equal to, I'm taking 10, and b also I'm taking is equal to 9, right? And two pointers I'm taking asterisk p comma asterisk q, right? Now see, simply first of all we will print value of a, right? So value of a equal to what format specifier percentage d and slash n simply for new line operator, because we will print many, I know, values. So a, so it will print value of a, right? So now we are initializing the pointer also. P is equal to, in p I am going to store address of a, right? And in q I am going to store address of b, right? So now another method to print this value of a is what? I am just going to go for this one, right? And how you can print? If you print asterisk p, then also it should give same output, like value of a would be printed. So I want to run this program and just see what output you will get here. See, value of a 10, value of a 10, both the cases are going to give you value of a, that is 10. Asterisk p also means value at address, address in p is address of a. So whatever the value of a, that would be printed. So now next thing you want to print, if suppose address of a and percentage, I want to print in hexadecimal form, right? I should use slash n here also, right? And now I am printing what? Address of a. Fine. One more method is what? Address of a is, in p also we are having address of a. So address of a is equal to, if you simply write here p, then also it should print address of a. So now let's see what output you are getting. See, value of a, first one, and then address of a is 61FEC4, 61FEC4. Both the lines will give you address of a. Fine. Now if you want to print like address of p, then simply you can write printf address of p percentage x I am using, and here, sorry, we are using comma, address of p I am going to print. So it should print like address of p. We don't know address of p. Let me run this program. And here, see, address of p is 61FEC0, right? Now if you want to print like whatever the value of b, simply you can write here like value of b is b, value of b is now asterisk q, because in q now we are having address of b, right? And here if you write something like this, if you write here like c is equal to asterisk p, and now I am printing c, c equal to percentage d slash n, and here I am printing whatever the value in c, right? Let me write down here also slash n, and first of all we'll what? Declare c here, right? Now what would be value of c? C, value of c is also 10, because in c I am storing asterisk p. Asterisk p means, asterisk means value at the address which is given in p. In p we have address of a, so address of a is what? Whatever the address of a, whatever the value at that address, value at that address is 10. So 10 would be assigned to c, and c will give you 10. And if you write something like this, comma, address of b, I am not using here Q anymore, right? So I am commenting this out. So now in P, what should be address of A comma address of B? Obviously address of A would be assigned, right? See, you can see value is, if you print asterisk P, then whatever the value of A, that would be printed, right? And if you write here something like this, in brackets I am writing address of A and address of B. Now what you output you will get? Now see the difference. See, now value of A is 10, but value of A here is 9 for second line. Asterisk P is printing 9. Now in P we have address of B. P is pointing to B now, right? If you want to know the working of this comma operator, then you can watch my previous video on the comma operator I have discussed, right, in the detail. So now I hope you got that, got this. Now asterisk of P is equal to C is also 9. In C also we have 9. I hope you got this, right? And if you write something like this, like in P we have address of B or address of A, and after this again P is equal to address of B. Now ultimately, finally, in B we will have address of, in P we will have address of B, right? See, value of A is 9. Asterisk P is giving you, the second line is giving you output 9, because in final, in P we have address of B now, right? Address of A has overwritten by this line, right? So I hope you got basics about this address of and dereferencing operator in pointers. And you can also do one thing like Q is also pointing to A. In Q also I am going to store address of A. So if you want to print here rather than asterisk P, if you print asterisk Q, right, that will also print whatever the value of A, that is 10. Let me run this now. See, second printf output is value of A is 10. Asterisk Q is also giving you 10, because in Q also we are having address of A. So two pointers are pointing to same variable A. That is also fine. So I guess that's it for this video. So in the next video we'll see what arithmetic operations we can perform on pointers. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.